Budget 2020 is just 2 days away, and right now economic issues are probably not making it to the top of your timelines or the news you are watching, but it's crucial. This budget is an opportunity to reset and a chance that cannot be squandered. The slowdown is no longer a subject that is restricted to boardrooms in between economists. The Aam Aadmi is feeling the pinch and talking about it. So before the big budget, let's get a sense of how the slowdown has impacted the Aam Aadmi. Today, we bring to you an exclusive pre-budget poll conducted by C-Voter. The budget tracker has interesting insights and shows how price rise or inflation has become a bigger issue now than it was ever in the 6 years of the Modi government. 72% of respondents, as per the latest tracker, say inflation has been unchecked and prices have gone up. The mood on incomes is also despondent, with nearly 44% respondents saying while incomes have remained the same, expenses have increased in the last 1 year. There are worries for the government on the economic performance front as well. The percentage of respondents that feel the performance of the government has been worse than expected has been steadily increasing since 2017. Is the government listening? And can this budget change the mood? To speak on this, I'm joined now by Yashwant Deshmukh, founder, editor of C-Voter International. We're also speaking with Gopal Krishna Agarwal of the BJP, Sunil Alag, as well as Madhavan Narayanan. Welcome to all of you and thank you for speaking with us. Yashwant, why don't you take us through the budget tracker first? Give us details of how large the sample size is and what really you've captured in this.
Well, in any case, the C-Voter tracker is done actually on a daily basis, all 365 days a year nationwide. And there are many items even in this budget tracker which are actually asked every day. But this particular budget tracker, out of which 9 items, most of them are the ones which we have been asking the respondents before the union budget. We have a timeline for almost about 10 years, a decade-long timeline for most of the questions. And what I can tell, I mean, with the timeline that is available for your viewers to see as well on the screen, that the numbers are not actually very, very encouraging. For the first time, you know, when we are tracking and the numbers starting with 2010, 11, 12, and right before the 2014 general elections, the worries about inflation, the worries about the rising costs, the worries about the income not matching really their expenditure, and worries about how a general common man is feeling the pinch on how about to go with their life, yeah, was high, really high around between 2010 to 2013 period. And all of a sudden, you know, that dropped after Mr. Modi comes to power in 2014. And since then, it has started going up slightly a bit again. It was not that alarming till last year. But I guess that this year's tracker is reaching somewhere in the range of 2013-2014 numbers, and that should be alarming. This is a nationwide survey. Please remember, every year we talk to more than 100,000 respondents in more than 10 languages, 11 languages to be precise, covering all the districts in all the states. So it can be as representative as it can get. This week's tracker has got approximately 4,000 samples, which is the updated number at this point of time.
Okay.
The trends which are there to see are worth pondering over.
Okay, Yashwant, just one more question, because you know we'll pull up those numbers again, and let's pull up the first one, which talks about the experience of inflation and of rising prices. The 2020 figures are, of course, the highest. But my question really is that this is just for the month of Jan. How representative is it? Can you explain that to us?
No, it's just a month for Jan, which you are on your screen. But the thing is that it is not that it is asked only in Jan. It has been asked almost every day throughout 2019 as well. And you remember during the course of election also, we did mention that, you know, when the headlines were coming out for the job lack of jobs or unemployment being an issue, as early as December 2015 itself, unemployment had become the top of the mind issue. But somehow that was not coming out as big alarming because the inflation was checked. For we have to give credit to the Modi government that at least in the first 4 years of the last 6 years, 5 years, 6 years tenure, the inflation was pretty much in control. It is only in the last 1 year that this issue of inflation has kind of come up really big time. It wasn't there for the last almost 5 years. This is something in 2019. You can say that sometime mid-2019 it has started surfacing, and right now it is reaching to some troublesome areas.
Okay, let me get a quick response from Gopal Agarwal. Mr. Agarwal, we're speaking, of course, just a couple of days before the budget. Price rise and inflation is something that the Modi government has focused on. Vegetable prices have contributed to inflation, so have climbing crude prices. But even if you look at the overall respondents on economic performance, that has also shown that there are more and more people unhappy with the government's economic performance. Is this the big challenge right now?
No, economy is always, Tamanna, is a challenge for everybody. It was a challenge in 1947, it was in 1991, it was in 2000, it was a challenge in 2014, and still there are certain challenges, and there will be challenges in the future also.
The thing is that
how do you understand those challenges and what you are doing to meet
Mr.
those
Agarwal,
challenges.
I'm sorry, I
so
will give you
important.
Complete time
if
to
the
respond,
economy,
but I, we are not speaking in 1947 or in the 2000s or in the 1990s. We are speaking today, 2 days before the first union budget of 2020.
We will speak
Let's
same
talk
in 2024. So there are challenges. We know consumer demand is a challenge. But I don't think inflation is a challenge at this point of time. Therefore, there may be concern that inflation should not rise. But inflation, controlling inflation is not a challenge at this moment. The only challenge at this moment, one of the important challenges, employment and the consumer demand. That's the most thing, private capital formation. These three are the important challenges, and government has very well a roadmap to meet those challenges. And whether it will be tackled in the budget or before also, I can very well assure everybody that government knows these challenges and is planning as a plan to meet those challenges. A lot of things will come in the budget as a policy statement or certain tweaking of some of the issues. But there has to meet these important challenges, there has to be a roadmap of 3 to 4 years, and we move that path. It doesn't mean that these challenges will be met after 4 years only. I say that there is a roadmap of 4 years, that doesn't mean that only after 4 years.
I understand roadmap.
We will start meeting.
Okay, let me focus on a couple of crucial things. Let me focus on a couple of crucial points over here, which emerged from the survey. That more people feel that their incomes are not rising, but their expenses are. And remember, this is as Aam Aadmi survey as it can get. So it's not a poll among CEOs or economists, Yashwant has explained how representative it is. So incomes are not rising, expenses are. So it is relative to that as well. Inflation has not been a challenge so far, but it is now beginning to be. The RBI says that as well. It's got its eye on inflation. The question is, Madhavan Narayanan, and I think the most important one, is the assessment of the economic performance of this government and what people are saying about that. What can be done and what will the government need to do to change that perception that they're lagging on the economic front?
I think apart from the survey which captures the mood, there are two ways of looking at it. One is to say inflation has been benign and therefore there is nothing for the government to worry about, and because there is also nothing by way of major protests against inflation, although there have been murmurs on onion prices and all. The fact is that politically speaking, we have been seeing more demonstrations against citizenship law or against corruption or in the case of farmers before elections last year. So politically, the government seems to be not too worried. But this is not a real picture because there is an eerie calm around this thing. Because there is something like a tiger by the tail situation where you have an economy of 1.25 billion people in which both inflation is creeping up again. It's not galloping inflation, but it's creeping inflation. And there is no demand and there is a real threat of unemployment growing.
Yeah.
So this is where the government has to be very careful. And for, you know, I just sketched out the scenario so that you can see where the challenges really lie. Let me also mention one more figure, which is the fiscal deficit, which is seemingly in control, but even the former finance secretary is talking about the real fiscal deficit being 5.5% because of off-budget issues, including Food Corporation of India. I mention this specially because Food Corporation is responsible for managing food subsidies, and I've just read a Reuters report that they are demanding 2 lakh crore more or something. They have been borrowing big time in market, like $2 billion equivalent. What does this all lead to? Leads to a situation where the government on the one hand has to ramp up spending, on the other hand manage food subsidies, and if it's supposed to control the subsidies, it means the inflation which has been hidden so far becomes more visible.
Yeah.
So it's a tiger by the tail situation for
all
the
right,
government.
You mentioned that.
It's
you mentioned that. Let's keep all our responses
and
brief.
Only,
Sunil Alag, you will get
let
one
me,
long,
let me complete,
long answer because
let
everyone
me complete
got a long
one.
Opening comment. But from here on, please keep your responses brief. Remember, viewers have short attention spans. Let's stick to the point and get a lot of points covered. Yes, Mr. Sunil Alag, what do you think is the big message? I'm sorry, Madhan, I'll come back to you, I promise. What is the big
yep.
message that needs to be taken away from some of the figures that we've presented over here? And the key two or three highlights is that more people feel that mehengai is pinching them. Mehengai is a tough word politically. Now, you know, the people who perhaps have been polled don't care what the CPI and WPI are. They care about how much money is going out of their pocket and what their incomes are.
Look, as far as I'm concerned, I've said it from July onwards, inflation is not the issue. It's just something which surfaces because you have not taken care of the demand side at all in the previous budget. People don't have the money. What have you done for us? So when they don't have the money, there is no demand. And therefore, the perception is that inflation is going up. It's gone up only in January. If you look at inflation, it's remained within 4 to 5% all along, 3, 4, 5, all along, and except the last one and a half months. So inflation is not the issue. The question is there is a lack of demand because people don't have the money. Once they don't have the money, then all these issues will come up. So I've always said that too much of the, we've swung towards the supply side. We've given a lot to industry. We've given a lot to everybody else to get the industry up, but we haven't given money into the hands of the consumer, which is what I've been screaming about right from July, that we have to do it. And if they don't do it now, first and foremost, the budget itself has little meaning now because they just announce policies in the budget and maybe one or two things will come up. It'll have to be a continuous process. So if you ask me, there are three things. One, government has to step up expenditure on infrastructure to create
yeah.
more employment. Second is they have to give more money into the hands of the consumers. Once they get more money, then all these issues will be taken care of.
No, but
ultimately, at the end of the day, you've also got the small scale guys who are begging for liquidity. And these are the three issues that the government has to face. And this time around, I do not think fiscal deficit, even if it goes up to 5%, it doesn't make a difference. The obsession of the government with fiscal deficit and the obsession with RBI on inflation is important in a developing economy. In a developing economy, even if inflation goes up to 6 to 7%, and I'm not recommending runaway
fall
inflation,
on high inflation,
but that shows
I'm
the
sure
economy
Yashwin
is developing.
To say about
but
it.
If consumers
inflation
don't have the money, forget it.
No, consumers don't have the money, but it depends on what is getting expensive. It depends on what is getting expensive. See the latest inflation numbers. It's all coming from the food
yeah.
basket.
Tamanna, exactly.
Yes, Yashwan, very quickly.
Exactly, Tamanna. I was going to say that what I loved about, always love about your program, you know, it's always one, you have got experts top to bottom approach, and also these kind of numbers which we are throwing from the bottoms up approach on how the public at large, the consumer at large or the voters at large are looking at the things. There are good, bad and ugly. I mean, I have for three quick points for all of them. Remember, in 2014, when there was a widespread agitation against UPA, there are three things on the people's concern which were they are putting in the red zone that, okay, these are absolutely problematic. Number one was corruption. Number two, inflation. Number three was the sense of national security. Now, obviously, the Modi government is still scoring very high as far as tackling corruption concerned. They don't get any bad marks for that. As far as national security is concerned, their image and their numbers, satisfaction ratings are very high. On the issue of inflation, for the 5 years, 4.5 years, it was nowhere having a problem. Yes, there was a problem of unemployment.
Right.
And as Mr. Alag just mentioned, since the last 6 months, he has been saying that, you know, the problem is of spending, having something in hand. Now, the thing is, in overall, when you look at it, there is an eerie silence. There is an eerie silence only because there are way too many emotive issues around for people to react to rather than react to the economic issues at this
today,
point of time.
Today, but on your timelines and your headlines, you're possibly not consuming much economic news, but you need to. It's important. It matters to people. It's what really matters. Gopal Agarwal, that's another question. Why is your government so focused on everything else but the economic issues? You've told us there are challenges. We will meet those challenges. We have a roadmap. We will follow that roadmap. That's essentially what you've told me so far. But
Tamanna,
Yeah, but to today say
Tamanna,
that inflation doesn't matter,
answers,
it matters to
I'll
the poor Indians.
And others also should. No, I'm telling you, inflation matters, but inflation is not a concern at this point of time. Inflation, if it is 8% or 9% or 10%, it definitely matters. So I'm telling at this point of time, inflation is not a concern for the economic policies. The second thing is, that Alag Saab said ki government is obsessed with fiscal deficit. No, it is not obsessed. Why we are announcing 105 lakh crores of investment plan over next 5 years on infrastructure pipelines? And neither we are talking about reducing any expenditure on the schemes which have created more liquidity in the rural and the lower strata of the population. So our idea is very clear. There has to be a liquidity into the lower strata of the population. Schemes like PM Kisan and Manrega and those affordable housing, this Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, Ayushman, they are doing good. And Ujwala, those will definitely give more liquidity to the lower strata. Agriculture and food processing in the rural areas require more liquidity. Credit line to NBFC and the retail financing company is in our cards. So we are not obsessed with either this fiscal deficit target, only figure sacros being calling
well,
them
global economists
or
will
we are
be
not
shuddering right now to hear you.
It's not a concern.
We don't care about fiscal deficit targets. Inflation,
no, let them shudder.
8-9%.
I'm not telling that. The issue is how do you tackle the economic problem of the current challenges, how do you meet them? And when everybody is agreeing that consumer need more liquidity, so that has to be provided.
Yes.
If the
but how? But how? You know,
support,
I want to come to this. Everyone keeps talking
if
about
the infrastructure
this.
Requires
for the last,
more.
For the last 3 months.
Give me 20 seconds more. I'm telling you how.
Okay.
Now, give me 20 seconds. Tamanna, 20 more seconds. The issue is we have to come out with alternative resource generation other than taxation. Either we monetization of the government assets or disinvestment or going to the new instruments of bond market, etc. That is the way we will generate the resources without going for more increase in taxation, etc.
You can't increase your borrowings.
With the constraint,
you can't
the government
increase
will move
your borrowings.
In that
sure, you can't increase your borrowings, beyond a point.
No, but private capital formation.
The fact is that everyone does care about the fiscal deficit.
Private capital formation come through bond market development, primary and secondary market.
Okay. Who wants to go in? Madhavan Narayan.
Is
there a plan? What is the plan that needs to come through? You know, everyone says that find ways to put more money in the hands of people. But it's not as easy as that, right? You're not going to give away wads of cash because you don't know where it's going to be spent.
Let me Let me say, we are sounding like a bunch of diagnosticians pretending to be doctors. We have the diagnosis. What we are looking for is a cure. So let's look at what are the possible cures. Mr. Agarwal listed some very good programs to put money in the hands of the poorer sections. But all we have so far is an announcement from the government of 102 lakh crore for infrastructure, which is not the same thing as putting money in the hands of the poorer sections of the people. I'm afraid there might be an asymmetry in the demand creation going forward, unless there is a magic rabbit out of the hat. The only sensible hypothesis I've come across in the past week discussing the budget is, let's say, something like a wealth tax for the super rich or an estate duty. Otherwise, in an economy that already lacks demand, how can you monetize by selling off assets? We are already sitting on the bank on a bank bubble, an IBC legacy issue of a bankruptcy court, which means that people are not carrying cash that can be easily deployed. And therefore, this has got to be an artwork of sorts in this budget in which, and you rightly said, Tamanna, that the world will be watching if there's a fiscal deficit issue.
Yeah,
if you're going to walk the tightrope between fiscal deficit, demand and inflation, it clearly means that what Sunil Alag said is the best option. Opt for a slightly higher inflation band. Now, of 6 to 7% instead of the 4 to 6 that we've been talking about.
We're already at 7%,
dear sirs. And use that elbow room to alter the skewness.
Everyone's talking about inflation as if it's not arrived
no,
yet.
No, that's only for 1 month, Tamanna. Yeah. That's only for 1 month.
No, yeah, but look at the graph, it's consistently rising. It's consistently rising. The fact is that inflation is at 7% for the last month. It might go away, but it is there. So let's not pretend it's not there, it's not an issue, and it's coming from food inflation.
Tamanna, I think Sunil...
It's not pretending you want to take for the full year,
Sunil
Tamanna.
Has a
you
point
can't
there.
Take for 1 month and aggregate it for the year.
Yes, but I'm saying that the RBI's next move will also depend on
There's
these
enough,
figures.
Tamanna, you're just taking 1 month inflation and aggregating for the year.
No, no,
and
I'm not going to aggregate
that's
in the beginning
wrong,
of the
year. That's very
wrong,
Tamanna, on
your part. No, I'm not aggregating for the year. The data is out there. Sunil Alag, you are saying inflation is not an issue. Gopal Krishna Agarwal is saying that
it's only 7% in January.
I'm saying we are at 7% for the last month.
What was inflation in
May,
June, July?
Let us see where we are. Anyway, I don't know why everyone's screaming. This is an economic debate.
What data are you talking about?
Less people
look
get confused,
the data,
they're watching
Tamanna,
something else. Let's
look
all
at
calm
the data
down. 1 minute.
Before you speak.
1 minute. 1 minute. 1 minute. Let's all calm down. Less people get confused.
We can calm down,
this
but Tamanna,
this is an economic
you must
debate.
Place
Mr.
the facts
Alag, you
correctly.
More than anyone. Please calm down. Okay,
don't
Yashwan Deshmukh.
The people, Tamanna.
Yashwan Deshmukh, let me come to your big takeaway. I will come to you, Mr. Alag. Please calm down, otherwise I'll have to mute you. Yes, Mr. Yashwan Deshmukh, let me come to the big takeaway that you have seen, because you were saying that this tracker happens on a regular basis. It happens before the budget. What do you think people want to see? And the fact is that for the Aam Aadmi, the budget is usually about whether there's a cut in taxes, if they are in those brackets. And it used to be about what became expensive and what didn't. What really would be required from the government as a big political message to tackle the story of the slowdown, which is now percolated through all the layers?
The question of liquidity, I mean, absolutely, how much money people have in their hand. The more money they are left to spend, the better it has to be. I understand. You see, I am not an economist, but I am the one who is probably coming up as the sentiment of the bottom of the pyramid, which I am putting across. Let's not forget that the two biggest of the mass chunks in India who have voted decisively for Mr. Modi, one is the females of this country and another the youth of this country, particularly the first-time voters and the real young ones below the age of 35. I guess these are the two major blocks. One has been supporting him in aspiration. Another one has been supporting because better quality of life, which Mr. Modi has generated through various schemes, starting from Ujjwala to right up to other schemes, which another guest of ours just pointed out. What I am simply trying to say, if you are not listening voices of protest, if you are not listening murmurs around this at this point of time, it is purely and only because of the trustworthiness of brand Modi. People still trust Mr. Modi and his brand that he is doing something to deliver. But that does not mean That does not mean that we stop reading the signings or signs of danger. Signs, you know, public doesn't understand the big technical jargons of economics.
Yeah.
All the things which experts talk about, the housewives in their kitchen, they do not understand that. The youth doesn't understand that. Youth wants a better future, better employability, good scope of employment, and the housewives need to know how they are running their kitchen. A good balance of this is what majority of the welfare scheme is about.
Yeah.
This is what I understand, and on the numbers, there are signs of worries. There are critical, I mean, you can see that there are fault lines now that are appearing on the numbers. So, I mean, I cannot put these numbers under the carpet and say, because...
No, there is no carpet. And I'm sure that the powers that be are also aware...
I don't think everything is
right. I'm sure that the powers that be are also aware that inflation is a number to be watched. And we have to see its trends and patterns over the next few months to come. Increasing incomes is key, not just... more number of jobs, but quality of income is key. And these are some of the key things that the Aam Aadmi wants. Any government which has been elected with an overwhelming majority by the Aam Aadmi will have to deliver. We'll wait and watch and see what comes out in the budget to this effect. I want to thank all of you all for joining us on the show this evening. Just 2 days to go. Remember, over the last few days on this show, you've seen a variety of voices and views, whether it's the millennial, whether it's corporate India, top economists, consumption experts. We've tried to get you every kind of viewpoint. There's a lot more coming up every day at 9 p.m. So I hope to see you back here tomorrow. Thanks for watching.